Hey everybody, I am going to do these colors on a 20 by 20 inch canvas, but with negative space. So it will be a bit different than that one because there will be white underneath the color. So let's see. Gonna have to make you a little taller. So hang on, peoples. You're getting taller right now. Which means I'm not even gonna be able to see. Okay. And I'm gonna have to stand on the table. There we go. Alrighty. Hopefully I don't have to lift it too much to tilt it. So as I said, this is a level 2 20 by 20 inch canvas from Michaels. To spray WD-40 silicone into it like I did on the other black can. And so we've got yellow, Artist Love green yellow, Grumbacher Prussian blue, Artist Love turquoise, and Soho dioxazine purple. This cup is 5.5 ounces. Most likely I will need more than that, but this is what I am starting with. So pretty in the cup. All right. Just set those aside. Spatula first to help spread it out. It's always the edges that are the hardest, but those can also just be touched up at the end. Usually I put way too much on, but I didn't want to over pour.
that sitting in my pan. Actually, do the finishing tilting of the white. Now that I'm actually tilting it, there's a lot more on here than I thought. So this white paint is Dutch Boy acrylic or latex house paint, interior house paint. I use satin finish, and the color is right off the shelf. It is the ultra white base. And I mix it with Floetrol and water. I don't measure, but if I had to venture, I'd say 60 paint, 30 Floetrol, 10 water. It's hard to say. It's more about the consistency, so sometimes one batch may have more Floetrol in it, one batch may have more water in it, but it's ultimately about the consistency. In my opinion, for this paint, not so much is there more or less water or Floetrol, if that makes sense. I don't know if it is going to tilt down. It does not appear to be moving. Alrighty. So, and this is kind of just gonna splotch down. Let's see if I can ease it at all, but yep, splot. I like to swirl it up. I like that. I really need to come up with a word that I like as the description of. It's kind of a softer look. You know, it's more softer and mixed, and I just don't know a good word to use. Off the side. I'm going to do my first torching of it. A bunch of white cells are going to pop up, and then I am going to be mixing it again. not want to move. Trying to recenter it. Better. That was just kind of a last spot. Didn't need to be there. Good look in the. Trying to see if there's any bare spots. From the cup edge, but surprisingly, I don't see any. While I've been messing with this part, they probably fill in. If you give them enough time, they will kind of suck back together. I'm gonna test how thick the paint is. Extremely. Did I just do that? Oh, it's this silicone. That looks like a nasty, just chunk of silicone. So what I'm actually going to do is take purple. Getting way too green. Now we have some color back to it. Oh, jeez. Alright. My shirt all in it. Just checking again if there's low spots. Cover where my laid my shirt in it. Shirt in it again. was a good choice I made to add the purple and the blue up here, because it was so green before, and this just really pops it. I kind of like how over here is like the webbing, so it's kind of a different look right over here. Give it one last torch. Right. Let's call this one complete.
Allow it to even get the whole thing in there. But thank you so much for watching. It says something went wrong. Part of this video may not be saved. I really hope that's not true. I will turn this off and go see. But I hope you got to see it all. And I will catch you next time. Bye.